The Unspoken Truth About Pests on Ag Day, brought to you by AgriSure Traits. Combine the power of AgriSure Duracade plus AgriSure Viptera trait stacks to control 16 yield-damaging above and below ground pests.
Armyworms are just one of the pests southern farmers are battling this year, and entomologists worry that pressure could be marching toward the Midwest. It's a true cost of pest pressure as we wrap up our series on the unspoken truth about pests. In the 40 years Gus Lorenz has focused on pests,
I can just tell you right now that this fall armyworm outbreak is the worst I've seen in my career.
The fall armyworm outbreak in Arkansas is one for the record books. It's a problem so potent this year.
A lot of times you can see them from, you know, the truck driving down the road, especially in some really bad situations.
And we can tell you based on that work that when you get around at Green Ring and you start looking, you get around 20% defoliation, it can cost you anywhere from 15 to even up to 50% yield loss.
And in soybeans, the surge in armyworm infestation can cause crop loss costs to add up quickly.
You know, yield losses a lot of times on late planted stuff, you know, range up to about 30-35% yield loss from defoliation on those small soybeans. Now you get later on in the growing season in reproductive soybeans, and it can be a lot higher than even that.
Farm Journal agronomist Ken Ferry says the true cost of pest pressure varies by insect.
We've seen corn borer pressures that amount to 30, 40 bushel to the acre. And we talk about rootworm, it depends on whether the rootworm pressure is heavy enough and the corn goes down. If the corn's still standing, it might be 7 to 10 bushel. If corn goes down, it can be 30 to 40 bushel. So things get out of hand pretty quick, depending on the type of insect.
But he says the cost doesn't just come from yield.
For instance, the issue of down corn, whether that be rootworm issue or maybe some corn borer issue, it slows down the harvest. So, and not only would it take away yields, it may double the amount of time in harvesting.
That's why agronomist Missy Bauer says timeliness is key.
Because if you go out here and you're too late, you've already had too much damage, then we've given up too much yields.
And it's not just in scouting, but in treatment.
You realize that you got silk clipping issues going on in your corn at tassel. You have nobody even lined up to potentially help you spray and take care of that, whether it's an airplane or a ground rig. You should always have your plan laid out, and then you add in, okay, now this is the scenario that I've gotten into. I just got to implement the plan that's laid out there. Because if you miss the boat on the timing side of it, we're behind the eight ball. We're giving up a lot of yield in a hurry.
For farmers in the South, the growing concern about pests this year aren't just armyworms. Plant bugs are bad too.
And so if you get three applications prior to bloom and you got four or five applications once the cotton starts blooming, then we're looking at maybe seven, eight, even nine applications to control this plant bug situation in cotton for a lot of our growers. It won't be everybody.
It's a quest to protect valuable bushels and pounds in the field. And Loren says every detail counts.